Good morning. Welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. My name is Marion Leone, and I will be the cantor at today's Mass. Our celebrant is our pastor, Father Bob Gorski, with Deacon Jay. The intention for today's Mass is Nick Green and Maria Anderson. Please see the bulletin for details on the Diocesan Eucharistic Revival to be held on Saturday, September 24th. Next weekend, parishioners are invited to bring fruits and vegetables from their garden to donate to the free community meal. Thank you so much for your support of our community meals. Please join us on Sundays at 3 p.m. in the church as we offer exposition, rosary, and benediction for the people of the Ukraine and the conversion of Putin's heart. The Office of Faith Formation will be hosting a back-to-school ice cream social after Mass today, and all are welcome. In order to preserve the sacredness of the Holy Mass, kindly silence your cell phones and any other electronic devices. Our gathering hymn, number 303, Gather Us In, number 303, verses 1 and 2. Please stand and take a moment to greet those around you as we begin this Eucharistic celebration.
Streaming, now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space our fears and our dreamings, brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in, the lost and forsaken. Gather us in, the blind and the lame. Call to us now, and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old, who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather us in, the rich and the haughty. Gather us in, the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly. Give us the courage to enter the song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. Welcome all of our young families who are here this morning for our Mass with children, and I believe following the ice cream social. So right after the Mass this morning, you look forward to ice cream downstairs in the hall, and also Trish in the parish office at the end of the hall. I have some fresh brownies if you want to add those to the ice cream. A little added incentive. Let's take a few moments now and call to mind our sins.
You show the humble your way, Lord have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You guide the poor and brokenhearted to justice. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You remember us all in your love and kindness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, I know their works and their thoughts, and I come to gather nations of every language. They shall come and see my glory. I will set among them, from them I will send fugitives. I will set a sign among them. From them I will send fugitives to the nations, to Tarshish, Put, and Lud, Mosok, Tubal, and Javan, to the distant coastlands that have never heard of my name or seen my glory, and they shall proclaim my glory among the nations. They shall bring all your brothers and sisters from all the nations as an offering to the Lord, on horses and in chariots, in carts, upon mules and dromedaries, to Jerusalem, my holy mountain, says the Lord. Just as the Israelites bring their offering to the house of the Lord in clean vessels, some of these I will take as priests and Levites, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. Praise the Lord, all you nations, glorify him, all you peoples. Go out to all the world and tell the good news. For steadfast is his kindness toward us, and the fidelity of the Lord endures forever. Go out to
a reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, You have forgotten the exhortation addressed to you as children. My son, do not disdain the discipline of the Lord, or lose heart when reproved by him. For whom the Lord loves, he disciplines. He scourges every son he acknowledges. Endure your trials as discipline. God treats you as sons. For what son is there whom his father does not discipline? At the time, all discipline seems a cause not for joy, but for pain. Yet later, it brings the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who are trained by it. So strengthen your drooping hands and your weak knees. Make straight paths for your feet, that what is lame may not be disjointed, but healed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. According to Luke. Jesus passed through towns and villages, teaching as he went and making his way to Jerusalem. Someone asked him, "Lord, will only a few people be saved?" He answered them, "Strive to enter through the narrow gate, for many, I tell you, will attempt to enter, but will not be strong enough. After the master of the house has arisen and locked the door, then will you stand outside knocking and saying, 'Lord, open the door for us.' He will say to you in reply, 'I do not know where you are from.' And you will say, 'We ate and drank in your company, and you taught in our streets.' Then he will say to you, 'I do not know where you are from. Depart from me, all you evildoers.' And there will be wailing and grinding of teeth when you see Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, and you yourselves cast out. And people will come from the east and the west, and from the north and the south, and will recline at table in the kingdom of God. For behold, some are last who will be first, and some who are first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. The Greek mathematician Euclid is considered the father of geometry. In his masterwork, Elements of Geometry, Euclid first compiled the theorems for measuring lines and angles and circles and planes that we still use today, 2,000 years later. In 300 BC, Ptolemy, then the pharaoh of Egypt, was fascinated with Euclid's book and sent for Euclid to come to Alexandria to teach him. But after a week of intense study, Ptolemy wasn't getting it. He complained, There must be a quicker, shorter method for teaching geometry to kings. Euclid humbly replied, Your Majesty, there is no royal road to geometry. There is no royal road to geometry. There are no shortcuts to solving complicated problems. There are no quick fixes to complex issues. There are only, as Jesus says this morning, narrow gates. Life is a series of narrow gates that we struggle through, and there is no easy, surefire, guaranteed safe way to pass through them. The narrow gate from child to teenager, the narrow gate from high school to college, the narrow gate from first job to established career, the narrow gate from dating to marriage, the narrow gate from spouse to parent, the narrow gate from life to death. Anything worth devoting our time and resources to, every situation we want to change for the better, every dream and goal we hope to realize can only happen through the gospel narrow gate. The narrow gates that Jesus talks about this morning are those gates that confront us that require an honesty and an integrity that we cannot fake, we cannot ignore our way through. The gospel narrow gate is the honest discernment of who we are, what we believe, what we hear God asking of us in the depths of our heart. There is no royal road to geometry. There are no shortcuts to solving our critical problems. There are no easy passages through life's complex and complicated transitions. The only way to wisdom and resolution is through the narrow gate. Oh, we try to sidestep a narrow gate or two along the way. We learn to rationalize, to hedge, to deny, to evade. But before long, we find ourselves still struggling through that narrow gate we thought we had found a way around. Whether we're trying to master geometry, or grow the perfect rose, or learn to play the guitar, or heal a rift with a friend, we can only do so through the narrow gate of humility and hard work. Narrow gates have no acceptable margin of error, no wiggle room, no escape hatch, no path of least resistance. Narrow gates require us to bend our egos and surrender our wills in order to pass through. To make our way through a narrow gate, we have to leave our compromised ethics and our obsession with winning at all costs behind. There is no royal road to geometry. There are no shortcuts to complicated problems. There is no way around a narrow gate. For us who seek to follow Jesus, narrow gates are the heart of what we believe as Christians. We believe in the crosses we bear in order to realize Jesus' resurrection in our lives. We're at the threshold of a critical narrow gate right now. The election of new leaders and legislators for our nation and state on November 8th. Too many politicians will promise us quick, painless, easy solutions to all our problems and crises and fears. But the reality is this. We can't solve the climate crisis until we dramatically change the way we produce and use energy. Affordable health care for all is a pipe dream until we make it a national priority. The working poor will continue to be the working poor until all of us who have realize our responsibility to all those who have not. All of these issues require from every one of us the resolve to change our lifestyles, and we're fooling ourselves if we think otherwise. Finger-pointing and second-guessing stop at the entrance to the narrow gate. It's not just them who have to change, it's all of us. We need to start thinking in terms of narrow gate solutions. There is no royal road to geometry. There are no shortcuts to understanding complicated issues. There are no painless solutions to our problems, and anyone who tries to tell us otherwise doesn't deserve our trust, let alone our vote. The narrow gate that Jesus speaks of in today's gospel is the demanding way of limitless love, unconditional forgiveness, and selfless giving. The narrow gate can only be entered by letting go of our fears, our control, our pride, our self-absorption. But it's only through the narrow gate that we can restore this good earth to what God created it to be. The only pathway to realizing God's kingdom of peace and justice for all God's daughters and sons. A kingdom, remember, that we pray every day will one day come. There is no royal road to geometry. There are no shortcuts to solving complicated problems. There are no cheat sheets for understanding the complexities of life 2,000 years after the mathematician Euclid. So may we open our hearts and minds to follow Jesus through life's many narrow gates. Narrow gates are the royal road to fulfilling the kingdom of God. On the other side of every narrow gate, we will find God's grace.
Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
The Lord who prepares the banquet for all will not turn away from our needs.
That Holy Scripture and the sacraments nourish and strengthen all believers, we pray to the Lord. That home, hearth, and hope for the future be restored to exiles and refugees, we pray to the Lord. That students and teachers starting a new school year make Christ and his truth the center of their studies, we pray to the Lord. That our community not lose heart under the Lord's discipline, but learn humility and patience through it, we pray to the Lord. That all those striving to enter heaven through the narrow gate of celibacy for the sake of Christ's kingdom will find strength and peace in their freely chosen discipline, we pray to the Lord. For all petitions brought to our shrine seeking the intercession of St. Jude, we pray to the Lord. For all of the sick, especially those whose names are listed in our parish bulletin, that God will heal them and restore them to good health, we pray to the Lord. And for what else shall we pray?
For the healing for Mark Seidel and Stephen Morris.
For these intentions, spoken and unspoken, for the people of the Ukraine, and for Nick Green and Maria Anderson, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of Abraham, you know our works and our thoughts. Gather our prayers and shower down your blessings upon us through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Please join in our presentation hymn number 438. O God, you search me, number 438.
O God, you search me and you
sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption, through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ who is our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. By rising from the dead, gave us life eternal. And so with angels and dark angels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy,
make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to one another the sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As we come to the Eucharistic table, our hymn is number 446, Amazing Grace, number 446.
Because
Towards the end of summer, every single year, we have a night of inquiry for those who might be interested in becoming Roman Catholic or completing their sacraments of initiation. I'm here to speak about that this morning is one of our team members, Diane Swinarski.
Good morning. As Father said, I'm Diane Swinarski. I'm a member of the RCIA team. RCIA stands for Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults. It is the way non-Catholics become Catholic. It is also the way in which Catholics who have not received their sacraments of First Penance, First Communion, and Confirmation can receive those sacraments. This process is available to both adults and children, and for children, it's known as RCIA Adapted for Children. Our team cannot do this alone. We need you, the parishioners, to pray for us and the candidates. We need you to be the models of Christian living, and we need you to welcome new people into our community. On Tuesday, September 6th at 6:30, the team will host a night of inquiry here in the church. At this time, the RCIA process will be explained and former candidates will share their experiences. We ask you to invite family, friends, neighbors, and coworkers to this night. It would be great if you could come with them too. Coming to this informative meeting does not commit anyone to anything. It takes the entire parish to run a successful RCIA process. If you are unable to come on Tuesday the 6th, but would like more information, please contact me in the parish office or Mary Carrigan, and the numbers are in the bulletin. Thank you for your time and prayers.
Thank you, Diane. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy. And perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord. Amen. As you leave church this morning, you'll find a letter from me at the front entrance of the church explaining more in more detail the night of inquiry for the RCIA. I would encourage you to take home a letter. Also, a little bit of a story regarding someone coming into the church through the RCIA. This is a number of years ago in another parish. We had a gentleman who was the husband of a Catholic woman from the parish. He was not Catholic, and he inquired and eventually went on to be baptized and confirmed and made his first communion and was fully received into the Roman Catholic Church. And after the Easter vigil, we had a reception downstairs in the church hall, and he and his wife and I were talking. And so I asked the gentleman, I said, you know, when did you decide you wanted to become Catholic? And he gave his reasons, explanation. And his wife said, well, I never knew you wanted to be Catholic. And his response to his wife was, well, you never asked. So sometimes it just means just asking someone if they might want to consider becoming a Roman Catholic. It can be a spouse, it can be a family member, it can be someone at work, a friend, a neighbor. Sometimes just extending a simple invitation can be enough to trigger something in someone's mind that says, well, I've been thinking about it, I think I'll look more into it. So it's up to us to extend that invitation. It may not always be accepted, but at least it's out there, and you never know how someone may respond in the affirmative and become a member of the church. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Our hymn of sending forth, number 741. A Rightful Place, number 741, verses 1 and 2.
live a life so that all might see that our hearts are restless till they rest in thee. Let us build your kingdom in truth and grace so that all might know we have a rightful place. Beauty ever ancient and new, breaking through our deafness so we hear you, shattering the darkness of night. A new dawn is rising to bring your light to all the world. Let us live our lives so that all might see that our hearts are restless till they rest in thee. Let us build your kingdom in truth and grace so that all might know we have a rightful place.
To gather in your presence we came, to be one in spirit and truth and name, strengthened by the body of Christ, taking up the call not to share your light with all the world.
Let us live our lives so that all might see that our hearts are restless till they rest in thee. Let us build your kingdom in truth and grace so that all might know they have a rightful place. Let us live our lives so that all might see that our hearts are restless till they rest in thee. Let us build your kingdom in truth and grace so that all might know they have a rightful place.